following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
Sesame Street. Listen, I'm really glad that you're here with Gillian and I today because, we're going to play a game with all these crazy things I have in this wagon in just a few minutes. And, let's see, Big Bird is going to be there with us to play the game, and Rico, and I wanted Ernie to play with us especially. And I asked him, I said, hey, Ernie, how about playing the game with us? But he said, no, I'm too busy.
Well,
you know what that means when Ernie says he's too busy, right? It probably means he's too busy eating cookies.
Let's see now. We got the two eyes and two ears and two noses.
Hey, you ding-a-ling. You've only got one nose.
Two noses and two eyes and two ears. Too bad.
Very funny. Very funny.
Hi, Bob.
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hey, what you doing?
Oh, we were just about to play that game that we were talking about, Big Bird.
Oh, boy, can I play?
Listen, we've been waiting for you to play. Do you know how to play?
Oh, sure, I know how to play almost any game. How do you play?
Sure you know how to play this game?
No.
All right, well, I was just about to explain it anyway to Rico and everybody, so this is the way it goes. You see, we're going to pretend that there were some animals visiting us here on Sesame Street today.
Oh, did they have a party? Did I miss them?
Well, they didn't exactly have a party, but they were here, and they left some things behind them, some clues, and we're going to try and decide what animals were here by the clues, the things they left behind them. Okay?
Oh, I'm good at that.
You ready for the first one?
Mm-hmm.
You ready, Rico?
Yes.
Gillian?
Yes.
Ready? Okay, here we go. Now, here is the first clue. Okay.
Wait, you got it upside down. Turn it over.
Turn it over?
Yeah, would you turn it over? Thank you. There, it's a sailor's hat.
No.
A sailor animal was here.
No, Big Bird, it goes this way. And it's a little bowl for water.
Bowl for water.
Right. First clue. Second clue. Now here is a little collar with a leash on it.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Now I know.
I'm going to set that right.
I know what it is.
Collar with a leash.
That's a collar with a leash.
Okay.
That's a bowl, and a little turtle lives in it, and that's a collar to put around his neck when he wants to go for a walk.
Not quite, Big Bird. Let's see if this last and final clue will help you discover what animal was here on Sesame Street.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Last clue.
Two
bones.
Two bones.
two biscuits. Gee,
this is hard.
Can you think?
You sure it wasn't a turtle? It
wasn't a turtle. Hey, listen, I bet Gillian knows. Gillian, what kind of an animal? Huh?
A dog, of course,
because that's a dog biscuit and a little dog bowl for some water. And here's the leash and a collar for a dog.
Oh, I knew that.
You knew that
all the
time, right?
Time.
Okay, we got another one. Let's see how you do on this one. First clue is a little bowl with some seeds in it.
Seeds.
Seeds in the bowl. Okay?
I wonder what they're... I have a tremendous urge to eat those seeds.
You like seeds, huh? Mm. Second clue. An egg.
An egg? Now, what kind of animal...
What kind of animal would like to eat seeds?
Lays eggs.
And lays eggs.
Do you have any other clues that might help?
One more clue, and you got to get it from this time, Big Bird, or you're just not going to make it. Okay, here's the last clue.
Uh-oh.
There are some feathers.
Feathers.
Now, we have feathers, seeds, and an egg. What animal was here on Sesame Street? Think hard, Big Bird. What was it?
Feathers, an egg, and some seed.
Right.
A dog.
Wrong again, Big Bird.
It was a dog before.
What kind of an animal do you think would that be?
A bird.
It could be a bird.
A bird.
Sure, it could be a bird, or I bet it might be a chicken, huh? How about a chicken? Do you think a chicken would lay an egg like that?
Yeah.
And he would like to eat seeds and have feathers like that, right?
Yeah.
Of course.
Okay, we've got one more now.
I knew it. I knew it had to be a chicken.
Now, we have here, this is a tough one. Mm-hmm. This is called a bridle.
Oh, a bridle. Somebody got married.
No, not a bride. A bridle, Big Bird. It goes around an animal's head, okay? Mm. And it helps you to steer that animal.
Steer.
Now, next clue. There is an iron shoe.
An iron shoe.
Now, what kind of an animal would wear an iron shoe and a bridle around its head?
A tap dancer.
Not quite.
Close,
yeah. Third and final clue, Big Bird. A nice big saddle.
A saddle.
Right. Now we have a saddle, and we have an iron shoe, and we have a bridle to go around the head. What kind of an animal would wear all those things? Think hard. Harder. Harder.
A bird. Wait a minute. Wait, I was close that time.
You're close.
A horsey.
A horse.
Did I get it right?
You got it right,
got
Big
it right.
Bird. That's terrific. I knew you could do it. Isn't Big Bird terrific? Hey, did you like that? Did you like that game, everybody?
Oh, sure.
Where are you going? Rhonda, I probably never told you about the time I was in South America. Ducked behind a eucalyptus tree and out popped a honey bear. And here he is. Look at him. He's also called a kinkajou. He's very active. He's not really a bear. You know that? Do you know that? You can tell me if you know.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. He's not really a bear. He's a distant but 10 and a half removed from a raccoon. Sort of in that family. He has a prehensile tail. You know what a prehensile tail is? That's a tail he can use in climbing. He can wrap his tail around things. He's trying to bite the chair. You got that banana?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, bring it out. Let's have the grand finale. You want to peel it for me? Just a little bit.
All
right. Do, do. Easy, my little kinkajou. He'll be straightened out here in a minute. Here, that's enough, that's good. Go. What do you want, the skin? Oh, I see. How about that? Good? Chiquita Banana be proud of you. Go. Look at that. He's found in very warm climates, you know that?
Yeah, my father told me.
Your father told you that? Good. Well, he is going through this banana like it's going out of style. Take it easy. It really goes for this. Well, he likes fruits and vegetables. When's the last time you had a banana, huh? Gone through that one. They got his breakfast, lunch, dinner, or what?
Lunch.
His lunch, huh? Well, he's down there in hot climates where bananas grow. And I can think of another animal that usually lives in very warm climates. You know what it is? It's a lizard.
Now that you know all about the alphabet, let's see what you know about stars. Remember what a star looks like? Well, it has straight lines like this. All these straight lines in it. And it has some points, too. Let's count and see how many points this star has. There's one, two, three, four, 5 points on this star. Okay, now you know what a star is, right? Now that you know the shape of a star, here's a little game. In this picture right here, there are some stars, only they're kind of hidden, and you have to see if you can find them in this picture, okay? Let's take a look very closely together at the things we have. Does this look like a star up here? No, that doesn't look like much of a star. It looks more like a circle, doesn't it? Because it has sort of round, curvy line. How about these trees over here? They have straight lines, and they have some points. Now, they still don't look like a star. They look more like a tree, huh? How about this house over here? That's not a star. That's a square. It has one, two, three, four sides and four corners. Another square for this chimney over here. A couple of triangles down here. This tree looks like a triangle. But I'll tell you something. There is one star hidden right around here. Did you find it? How about this tree over here? Here's the trunk of the tree, and the limbs go out here. See any stars in that tree? Now, I'll give you another clue. There are two stars hidden right in this tree somewhere, right around in here. Now, in case you didn't find the stars when we looked at this picture just now, I'm going to count to three. And on the magic count of three, these stars are going to light up. Okay? Here we go. One, two, three. How about that? Do you see them now? Here are two stars right here. One, two, with all their points. And here's the third star right here with one, two, three, four, 5 points. As a matter of fact, I think it's the same exact size as the star I showed you in the beginning. I bet you found them all, didn't you? You know, stars are really pretty. You could draw your own star, or if your folks let you, you could stay up late at night sometime and look out at the sky and you'd see the stars there. Or you could sing a song about a star.
Big Bird,
mm-hmm.
If you were going to get from here, mm-hmm. where you are now,
yes.
over to the steps of 123 Sesame Street, just how would you go about it?
Well, how would I get over to the steps? Well, I'd just walk. That's all, Gordon. That's
oh, yeah?
easy enough.
All right, let me see you do it.
You want to see me walk?
Sure.
Sure.
Let me see you do
it. Ta-da. Here I am. I'll walk back.
No.
Was that easy?
That was very good, Big Bird.
Thank you.
Now, can you think of another way, other than walking, to get from here to the steps of 123 Sesame Street?
Another way besides walking?
Another way.
Well, it's not far enough to take a bus.
No.
And I can't fly. Mm. Well, there's no other way to get from here to the steps without walking, Gordon.
Well, fear not, Big Bird. Gillian may have a way. Let me check. Gillian, can you think of another way other than walking to get from here to the steps?
Yes, I can.
You can, huh? Take off and show me.
Oh, look, she's running.
right?
She ran to the steps.
She ran?
Why, there's two ways to get from here to the steps.
Oh, yeah.
Walking and running.
Mm-hmm. Now, I can even show you another way.
You can?
Another way, with the help of my friend Rhonda. Rhonda, can you think of another way besides walking or running to get from here to the steps?
Yes, I can.
Well, lay it on me. Go ahead.
She's skipping, Gordon.
She's skipping.
Skipping, that's skipping. Another way of using your legs. You can run, or you can skip, or walk, like I did.
That's three. You think that's all?
Well, I imagine so. That's a lot of ways.
Well, it's a lot of ways, but I bet you I can come up with one more.
Really?
Let me consult with Gillian for a moment. Gillian, can you think of another way besides walking, running, and skipping to get from here to the steps?
Yes, I can.
You can?
You kidding me? You another way? Go, 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 do it.
She's hopping.
She's hopping.
She's hopping. Hopping.
How about that?
That's great, you know?
Yeah.
Hopping, skipping,
right.
And running.
Uh-huh.
You know, Gordon, I was gonna just walk home.
Well, anybody could do that.
Yeah, but now I'm going to hop and skip and run all the way back to my nest.
Oh,
we'll see ya.
So long, Big Bird.
Bye.
Bye, Big Bird. Boy, he sure is enthusiastic now. Let's go help. Let's go help him up. Come on, Big Bird. Oh, easy. Easy, Big Bird. Easy, Big Bird. Oh.
I got all dusty on the sidewalk. There. There, better now. Boy, you know, hopping, skipping, and running are fun. But I just think I'll walk from now on.
Oh,
goodbye.
Really? Okay, goodbye, Big Bird. Whew. Well, Big Bird shouldn't feel too bad. He's not the only one who has trouble getting around, you know. Uh-huh. There's another young fellow who has trouble getting around. That's a baby reindeer. You know, when these pictures were taken, he was only a few hours old. 3 hours and 27 minutes, to be exact. First thing he has to do is learn how to walk, because his legs are just a little bit wobbly now. So that's Mama Reindeer there, and she's got to help him out a little bit. And she's got a great way to make him walk. See, the baby reindeer needs milk. He has to go to his mother to get the milk. And the only way he can keep up with his mother is to walk, even though his legs are a little bit wobbly. See? He goes to the mother, the mother moves away, so he's got to walk. Now, she's going to give him some milk. Don't worry about that. But first, he has to learn how to walk. I think he's going to make it. Ah, he made it. He made it. Getting a nice, long drink of reindeer milk. Mmm. Boy, is that stuff good. Look at the reindeer milk. Now, oh, down again.
Yeah, some of us are here. But not all of us. Now none of us are there. Now some of us are here. But not all of us. Now none of us are there. But now
all of us are here.
Okay, you hear that music? You know what that means. It's time to play One of These Things Is Not Like the Others. One of these things is not like the others. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the others by the time I've finished my song? Now look at each one carefully before you make your decision, okay? La-dee-da. Da 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 Did you guess which thing is not like the others? Did you guess which thing doesn't belong? If you guess this thing is not like the others, then you're right. And I'm going to tell you why for those of you who didn't get it right. Now, look at each one. This arrow goes both to the right and to the left. This arrow goes to the right and to the left. This arrow goes to the right and to the left. But this arrow only goes to the right. So this is the one that's different. And these three, one, two, three, are the same.
And you know what Rico and I have right here? We have a magnet. Do you know what a magnet can do? That's right, it can pick up pieces of metal. Now this is sort of a small magnet, but watch how we pick up these nails. Comes right down, zip, and picks those nails right up. Isn't that great? That's what a magnet can do. Now this is kind of a small magnet, and it can pick up nails and things like that, but sometimes there are magnets so big they can pick up a whole car one time. Do you know that, Rico?
Yeah.
Now why don't you pretend that you're a giant magnet, magnetic crane, and you start your motor up and see if you can pick up this car right by the roof, okay? Get your motor going. Right down on top of that car. Way to go. Now see if you can pick it up. Hey, that's terrific, Rico. Hey, how would you like to be that strong, Rico, that you could pick up a whole car?
I would like it.
Would you like that?
Yeah.
Hey, listen what I hear. Do you hear what I hear up there?
Yeah.
It's our old Skywriter. There he is, right over there. See him?
Yeah.
I wonder what he's going to write for us today. Maybe he's going to draw us a picture of an ice cream cone just for a change, you think? No?
Maybe it's an L.
An L? Yeah, it looks like an I right now. Could be an L, though. Could be a D. They both start with straight lines up and down, don't they?
Could be a B.
Yeah, a B starts with a line like that. Hey, there he goes across the bottom. What's it look like?
L.
Looks like an L right now.
I don't think it's going to be that.
You think he's finished yet?
Nope.
Sounds like he's still going, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, there he goes, right across the top. Maybe he's drawing us a big box.
Full of ice cream.
Full of ice cream? Wouldn't you like that, huh?
Yeah, a window.
A window? Ah, there he goes again. What's it look like now, Rico?
An E.
Looks like a big letter E. Look at that E up there. Oh, isn't that one of the biggest E's you've ever seen?
Yeah.
Hey, can you think of any word that starts with the letter E, Rico?
Yeah, easy.
Easy. Sure, that's an E word, isn't it?
Yeah.
I can think of a couple of them, too. You know, ear. That's an E word. And let's see, elbow, that's another word that starts with the letter E. You know, usually the letter E has one of two different sounds. Either it sounds like E, as in ear, or it sounds like eh, as in elbow. Those are the two sounds that the letter E makes, either E or eh. Now, I can think of an animal, a bird, that begins with an E sound. Can you think what it is? It's an eagle. And I can think of another animal that begins with the other E sound, eh. Can you think of it?
That's right, E is for elephant. But this isn't any elephant. You know who this is?
It's a dove.
Yeah, Donald Dove. That's Donald Dove there. He's a banded dove. You know what that means?
No.
Would you like to know?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you. See around his neck?
Yeah.
That's a band of another color. That's black around his neck. And he is a kind of very light brown.
Why does he have it on his neck?
Why does he have it on his neck? Well, because he's a banded dove. And therefore, he'd have to have a band. Otherwise, he wouldn't be a banded dove, right? Can you see, Rhonda? Slide back over here so you can see. It's like a ring-tailed monkey. He'd have to have a ring around his tail, otherwise he wouldn't be a ring-tailed monkey, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ah, 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 ah. This dove is very happy here and very peaceful. That's why they're the symbol of peace. Because they're very peaceful.
Yeah. Birds are sometimes very nice.
Birds are often very nice.
But when you try to catch them, they just fly away. But first, they might bite you or something.
Oh, yeah? Well, that depends on the kind of bird it is.
Yeah.
But this is a dove. This is Donald Dove. Never saw a cross word in his life. But he never even said goodbye, like I have to say now. But we're gonna be here on Sesame Street, so you come back and join us, okay? That's a promise. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E, S, and W, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.